Hello, nice to see you again after a beautiful
Hello.
vacation. Hello, everyone.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon.
Hi, teacher. Thank
Hello.
You.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Dominga, Wendy, Mayra. Hello, Carla, Ana Daisy,
Hi,
Lilia.
Hi.
Hello, how are you? Karen. Bernice, Melvin, Lizzie, Astrid, Marvin, we have Pamela, we have Andrea, Astrid, thank you, very Imelda, thank you, welcome. Thank you so very much for being here on time. Let's see who else is here. All right, we have Jose Cartagena joining right now. Thank you very much, Jose. Welcome. After a good 8-9 days, something like that, of vacations. That's good. Tell me about your vacations. What did you do? Did you go to the beach? Did you go to La Feria, the fair? Did you go to I don't know, the roller coaster, La Montaña Rusa? No? What do you
no.
do? No? What do you
no.
do? What do you do on vacation? Tell me about your vacations.
Teacher, my vacation was very, very horrible.
Oh, my goodness.
Terrible.
Why?
Because in the end, my husband was sick. And then my baby was sick too.
Oh gosh.
And we don't out anywhere.
You didn't go out anywhere. All right, maybe just at home, right? Taking care of your babies and your husband.
Yes,
right?
sir.
All right, that's good. I mean, not good that they got sick, but it is what it is, right?
Yes, but we have a very good time together, maybe because no time is here without my
husband.
Oh,
all right. He's not always there. Okay.
Yes.
So you
we
took
drink some coconuts and
ooh, delicious.
Very different for this day, but
excellent.
It was, well, maybe.
Perfect. All right.
Terrible because they were sick. No.
Yes, that's true. It was an unusual vacation because they were sick, but at the end, you were together like a family. Which is good. All right. Yeah. Thank you for sharing, Anna. What about the others? What about Astrid? What about Pamela? What about Andrea? What about Imelda? What do you do? What do you do on vacations? In the activity, do you remember the activity that we had last Friday, right? You told me that I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna go ahead and do this one, I'm gonna go ahead and navigate. Oh, so that was a lie, right? So you were making
a good dream.
All right. Okay. So that was your dream vacation, right? Okay. Understood. Very good, girls and guys, right now. So let me say this in Spanish. El día de ahora, en teoría, terminaríamos la unidad 4. Por lo tanto, eso indica que la unidad 4, el examen de la unidad 4, usted lo va a entregar en lo que resta del día de ahora y lo que viene el día de mañana. O sea que tienen lo de la noche y mañana antes de la clase para que usted entregue su screenshot del examen de la unidad 4. 3 de ustedes ya lo hicieron, ya me mandaron la nota. Y ya lo hicieron el fin de semana, aprovecharon. Y ahí tengo la nota ya de Ana Daisy, de Dominga y de, no me acuerdo, de alguien más. No me acuerdo, de una de ustedes. que ya tengo las notas. Ya lo hicieron, perfecto. Así que, asegúrense de mandar. All right.
Teacher, I have a question. Yo ya voy trabajando la unidad 5, pero yo no recuerdo haber visto examen de la unidad 4.
Yes, there is one exam. Hay un examen de la unidad 3 y 4. Ahí está. Entonces, váyase un poquito más para atrás en la plataforma. Debe decir unidad 3 y 4. Ahí usted lo hace y me manda ahí el screenshot with the score. All right. Quiero enseñarles cómo vamos en la plataforma para que ustedes vean que no todos trabajan al mismo nivel. Es decir, unos, por alguna circunstancia que yo desconozco, se han quedado demasiado atrás. Solo tenemos 4 días, descontando el día de ahora. Tenemos 4 días. Les tocará en 4 días hacer 4 unidades a los que van atrasados. Aproximadamente, ok, les voy a enseñar esto. Aproximadamente usted tendría que llevar, voy a agarrar el ejemplo de Carla. De Carla y de Mayra. No. ¿Quién es Argueta Vázquez?
Yo, Andrea.
Ok, thank you, Andrea. Voy a agarrar el ejemplo de Andrea y de Carla. Vaya, más o menos por este porcentaje deberían andar todos, que es el 80. Andrea, creo que tú vas un poco más adelantada, pero más o menos por ahí, por el 79-80% de la plataforma deberían andar todos. Porque ya estamos a punto de terminar la unidad 3, la unidad, 5. Ahora vean esta persona, por ejemplo, aquí hay 38, 39, tengo con 22%, aquí vamos bien, a ver, otra más por acá, aquí vamos bien. Digamos que el 66 todavía es muy poquito, pero es pasable. All right. Tenemos 36%. Entonces, yo necesito que se pongan las pilas, que you shape it up. You shape up, okay? Oops, para que la nota no les quede tan baja, porque yo la nota la agarro lo que usted tiene. Y si usted tiene 22%, le va a quedar a 2.2 su nota de plataforma. Y ahí se va a venir el bajón, y aunque usted lleve 10, 10, 10, eso le va a afectar un gran montón y puede hacer que ya no por la plataforma usted no llegue al puntaje deseado. ¿Verdad? Melvin, do you have any question?
Yes, tenemos hasta mañana, dijo, para mandar el examen.
Yes.
Para y mandar el examen. Y lo que resta 3, de 4. Estos días es para terminar la unidad 5 y hacer el otro examen.
No.
No.
Tienen ahora y mañana para terminar la unidad 3 y 4. De hecho, Melvin, por alguna razón, yo no tengo tu examen de la unidad 1 y 2. Entonces.
Ah, no, es que ese sí no lo hice porque no se me olvidó. Alright.
So please send it porque tenés 0 en eso. Entonces, please.
Igual se lo envío.
Yes. Okay. Very good.
Ah, okay. Ah. Es que yo sí lo hice, pero como ya no lo entregué, entonces solo lo hice en la plataforma, pero no tomé ninguna screen.
Exactly. So just send me the screenshot so I can put you a score. So tienen
ahora y mañana. ¿Tenemos hasta el viernes para?
No, tienen ahora y mañana para entregar la unidad 4.
Ajá.
La unidad 3 y 4. Ahora vamos a empezar con la unidad 5. O sea que la terminaríamos el viernes o el jueves. Por esos días, le voy a ir avisando, usted termina la unidad 5, que es el examen de la unidad 5 es una compilación de todas las unidades, de la 1 a la 5, all right? Si usted lo hace, si usted lo termina, no sé, por ejemplo, mañana, usted me manda Este es el de la unidad 5. That's it. Yo le pongo su nota de la unidad 5. All right. Sin embargo, la unidad la vamos a empezar hoy. Ok. So tenemos okay. un par de días. El viernes terminamos las clases. Ok. El viernes terminamos las clases y eso indica que las notas de ustedes se van para Insafort el lunes a las 7 de la mañana. Entonces, tendrían los que no, por cualquier motivo, no lo hagan el examen en esta semana, tienen sábado y domingo para mandarlo. Ya, si usted me lo manda el lunes en la mañana, eso ya se fue, porque yo mando el reporte tempranísimo para Gisela y ella manda el reporte para Insafort. ¿Ok?
Teacher, y las notas del examen oral las compartió. Yo no. Hasta hoy he entrado al grupo. Ajá.
Exactly. A ver, se las voy a mandar ahorita. Yo se las mando, déjame ver. Ta-da-da. Let's see. Yo se las mando ahorita y usted las ve con tiempo. Ok, y las vemos después de la clase o me manda un mensaje, me dice teacher, esa no es mi nota. All right, so
I have a question.
Sure.
Teacher, es solo una pregunta. Siempre se va a sostener, yo sé que nos mandaron ahí lo de los módulos, ¿verdad? O sea que definitivamente, si empezamos con este horario, los 12 meses, los 12 meses del año, vamos a seguir con este mismo horario.
No.
Ya no lo vamos a poder cambiar. O sí, sí me puedo cambiar ahorita.
Cambie siempre y cuando, como les explicaba, haya disponibilidad. Exacto.
Vaya.
Porque, y si puede mandarle un mensaje a Gisela, porque eso lo maneja Gisela estrictamente.
Vaya.
Entonces, uh-huh. para que vea si en el siguiente grupo que va a abrir, hay disponibilidad de otro horario para que la pueda meter a usted.
Vale, de acuerdo, gracias,
teacher. All right, very good. Okay, people, so we are going to start right now. Thank you for those who are joining here. Thank you, Kenny. Thank you, Wilburn, Diana. Who else? Let's see. Marvin, welcome, Marvin. Welcome, Rodrigo, welcome. Nice to see you here. All right, so let me show you this. Oh, a propósito. Hay algunas personas, 3 o 4, que incluso ya pasaron la materia, all right? Por las buenas notas que tienen y por lo que más ayuda, créanlo o no, es su participación. Cuando ustedes vean sus notas, hay una que dice speaking. Esa es la nota que llevan hasta ahora, no es la que les va a quedar. Esa nota puede mejorar si usted participa. All right. Si no participa, pues esa nota es la que lleva hasta ahora. All right. Así que si usted participa, esa nota le puede aumentar y le puede ayudar a subir la nota global un poco más. Ok. Si tienen dudas de sus notas, me avisan de forma personal en el WhatsApp. Ok. La duda que usted tenga. All right. So let's begin. Let me show you this. I'm gonna show you this picture. The question is, let's see, Carla Ayala, what is the question?
What do you know about?
Okay. Who knows this city? What's the name of this city? Oh, this one.
New York.
Okay, perfect. This is New York City. Perfect, Manhattan. Now, what do you know about this city? What do you know about? What have you heard? Tell me something that you have heard, that you have read, that you know about New York. What are the things that you know about it?
Teacher, I listened that New York or Manhattan is the city very moved.
Okay.
And very funny too.
Okay, very funny city. Very, very hectic, is kind of crazy. Everybody is super fast. Okay, thank you, Anna. Anybody else?
Me?
All right, go ahead.
Se dice mucho comercio.
Very nice.
A lot of businesses.
The movies.
All right. Oh, Kenny, can you repeat that?
The movies, film okay. Here.
Okay. This is a city of a lot of movies. Yep, that is correct. Another?
Very noisy. No sé, noisy.
Yeah, very noisy. That's true. That is very true. It's very noisy. What else?
It's very chilly. It's correct.
Chilly? Like cold?
Cold, uh-huh.
Yeah, in the winter, it's very chilly. In the summer, it's super hot, too. Yep. Another?
Broadway?
Teacher, Grom is for casinos. Oh, casinos, yeah. There are a lot of casinos. Maybe not like Las Vegas, but there are a lot of casinos here. Yeah, that's true. Thank you, Dominga. Very nice.
Broadway?
Come again?
Broadway?
Oh, Broadway. Good. In fact, a propósito, in fact, this part is Broadway. It's all of this. Ooh, there are blocks and blocks and blocks of Broadway. It's an avenue, right? Broadway Avenue. It's a large avenue for many, where you can find many theaters. All right. Thank you, Berenice. Anybody else?
Many people work.
All right. A lot of people is working there. Very good. One more.
The restaurant.
Okay. A lot of restaurants. Good. One more.
Times Square.
Times, yeah.
This is Trade Center.
Yes. Ooh, there are a lot of taxis. A lot of taxes. All right. There is one more important thing about New York.
Buildings.
Okay. Buildings. How do you say rascacielos? Do you know the word for that?
For falls, algo así.
Kind of. Skyscrapers, rascacielos. So there are a lot of skyscrapers. All right, very good. Can you tell me the name of two famous buildings in New York? Buildings, skyscrapers, rascacielos. Two famous skyscrapers in New York. The World Trade Center. Okay, that's one.
Empire
that
State.
Is one. And
Empire State.
Good. Empire State. The Empire State Building. Very good. Awesome. Okay, now let's change the picture. What do you know? What city is this?
Wow.
Sydney,
San Francisco,
LA.
LA. Yep, Los Angeles. Very good, very good. So, tell me something that you know about LA.
Teacher, somebody say that Los Angeles is like a Central America.
Like because Central America?
It's a lot of people, a lot of business, it's so hot.
It's extremely hot. Yeah. Uh-huh. It's very hot. However, in winter, it's very cold too. It's very cold. Maybe not like New York or Chicago or something like that, but it's very cold, right?
There never snow.
No. In Los Angeles, no. But if you go to like to the
north. Only la mountains.
Yeah,
la exactly. Montaña.
You go to the northern part of Los Angeles, yeah, we can find snow. But in Los Angeles, no, it doesn't snow, right? All right. So what else do you know about Los Angeles? A lot of people, a lot of Hollywood. Mexican people. Oh, Hollywood. Thank you, Wilbur. We can find Hollywood. What else?
The Universal Park.
Oh, Mountain. Universal
Magic Studios. Mountain, Universal.
Yeah, and Magic Mountain. Good, good.
It's not very far, también. It's not very far.
What is that?
It's not very far. Es de la de todas las que son del del de la época antigua de del que que sacaban el el oro de como
oh
de,
como all right de, that is correct.
Disneylandia, yeah. Disneyland.
Disneyland, very good, uh-huh. Very good. All right, people. So you know about LA and New York. So we are going to do another activity right now. I'm gonna go ahead and send you a video right here. You know, because of the copyright and all that stuff, I cannot present the video. En otros puedo correr el riesgo de presentarlo aquí, pero este es de un programa bien famoso y no vaya a ser que nos vayan a mutear el video y nos quiten el video. So, this is an interview, all right? So, you're going to listen this interview and on your notebooks, this is individual exercise, all right? On your notebook, you are going to write what the kids, this is an interview made to kids, all right? Kids from LA, kids from New York, children, children from New York, children from LA. So they ask children from LA what they think about children from New York and vice versa. All right, this is an interview about. So let me give you the link for the video. It's only like 3 minutes, four minutes. It's a 4 minute video, all right? So let me give you the link right now. It's there, okay? It is there. So you can open the link. Let's do something. Para que hagamos una brainstorming, una lluvia de ideas, we're gonna do it in groups. No tan grandes, pero in groups, all right? So let me put right here. Let's see, let me create the groups right now. Maybe four groups only, all right. You know what to do, right? Someone in the group, please share. Alguien, please share with a computer, share the video, and you share the ideas. So what you need to do is on your notebook, write two things from LA and two things from New York, all right? What is the opinion that children have from LA and the opinion they have from New York, all right? So do you have the video ready? Yep. All right, let's go to the rooms, please. Let's go right now. Let's go to the rooms. I'm gonna give you seven minutes. All right, let's go. 7 minutes to complete the activity. Let's go right now. All right, let's go, everyone. Let's go, Carl. Let's go, Diana, Andrea. Let's go, please. Let's go, Melvin, Rodrigo.
Teacher, quiero aprovechar algo. Teacher.
All right.
Tengo cero en el examen oral.
In the oral exam?
Why, really? Teacher?
Okay,
why?
Give me just one moment. Let's see. Aquí las tengo enfrente. Vamos a ver. Mayra, no, Mayra, no tiene cero.
No es la dos, o examen oral dos, que no es.
Yes. Yo tengo cero a ti.
Oh, okay. Pues les he mandado el grid incorrecto. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. A ver, okay. A ver, vean aquí rapidito. ¿Lo pueden ver?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Mayra, 9. Uh-huh. ¿Quién más?
Yo no sé el mío, no he visto.
El último. ¿Quién es el último? 6.5, 9.5. Se los voy a mandar. Perdón.
Yo soy el 4.
O sea que les mandé uno que no era, perdón. All right. Ya se los voy a mandar. Okay. El correcto, ¿ok? Para que lo vean con detenidamente, ¿ok? So, okay. Please, okay. Now, share. Gracias, Mayra, porque si no me dice, se van todos con cero. All right. All right. Thank you. Let's go. Let's go.
Okay.
Okay, teacher. Thank you.
Me avisan si.
Nasty and people are so sometimes rude.
What kind of nasty things are there?
Like rats and a baseball team.
Who has a better baseball team, New York or LA?
New York Mets. Well, this year, because remember? Mets.
Who's better, the Mets or the Dodgers?
The Yankees.
What do you think about people from LA?
I hate him, but wait.
How come?
Because he broke one of the Mets' legs.
What's the worst thing about New York?
Donald Trump's there.
He's the dumbest person in LA.
Probably a manager of the LA Dodgers.
What do people in New York complain most about?
Maybe that it's too busy.
Yeah. And what do you think people in LA complain most about?
That there's too much gluten in the world.
Who's smarter, people in New York or LA?
Definitely New York.
How come you guys are smarter?
A lot of people know how to do things way faster. And people grow up way faster. But I age way faster. Like today I'm like this big. Yesterday I was like this big.
Oh
my God. Quizás porque no se puede. Con el audio no se puede.
Sí, hay que escucharlo cada una mejor y luego lo compartimos las opiniones.
Ok.
Entonces veámoslo personalmente.
All right. Let's begin. So, let's see right now. Marvin, tell me something that you heard in the video. Something that you heard about children from New York or children from LA. Let's go, Marvin.
And the children in LA, they say que en New York había mucha gente nasty and something rude and too much Galvin. I don't know what is that.
Too much what?
Galvin, I think.
Galvin or garbage? No.
Garbage es como basura.
Yeah, garbage is como basura, right? Like rubbish.
I don't know, no entendí muy bien esa palabra.
Okay. Okay. Maybe it's dirty, yeah. That is true. Okay, anybody else? Let's see. Andrea, what, thank you, Marvin. Andrea, what did you hear about kids from LA and kids from New York?
Okay. In LA, they're kind of cranky.
All right.
Ignore you when you go there.
That's true.
Not really on the price.
Okay.
Like strong, and people are crazy in LA. In New York.
All right.
In New York, it mostly into plastic surgery.
All right. Okay.
Very nasty and sometimes rude. The best team of baseball is Mets and Dodgers.
Okay.
And he say Donald Trump's there. He's a dumbest person.
All right. Thank you, Andrea. Very good. Thank you very much. Good. That was a good sentences right there. Anybody else? Let's participate. The more you participate, the better grade you will have. Let's continue with the next person. Who is this? Let's see. Andrea Reyes.
Yes, teacher. Right. And the guy say, tu relación, ay, no sé, no puedo decir relacionar, perdón.
To relate
but to relate the rat in New York and the noisy.
All right.
Say it in, I don't know in LA or in New York, but say they grow up fast.
Come again? The what?
Grow up fast.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And nasty and say to the girl says that. Busy, New York is too busy.
It's too busy.
And LA say, go shopping.
All right, let's go shopping. That's true.
No more.
Excellent, Andrea. Very good. I like that. Any other volunteer?
Teacher, it's like, it's like the people say. I think because the words are very common in our language that we understand. Because LA says that in New York is too much crazy people, nasty. They have so many rules. And there is Donald Trump's, and other people say that they like to go shopping. And I listened in the group that the one say that there is Kim Kardashian.
But right.
In the group we say the child have a mental like a adult. Because they are think about the ease or other ones, what the places, the
west
north
side.
And the south.
West side and east side.
Uh-huh. And this is that the group says about the some child says.
Perfect. Very good. Very good. Good opinions. One more. I need one more. Kenny?
Oh, the life is more cheap in LA than New York.
That is correct. That is true. Life is cheaper in LA and it's truly expensive in New York. Who has visited New York? Who has visited New York? No? Who has visited LA?
For video.
All right.
For video cam, yes, teacher.
All right. Yeah. It's the life is different, totally different. For some reason, New York and California, they have like a rivalry, right? They are rivals. I don't know why, but it's like a competition between both states. Okay, guys. Excellent. I like those opinions. Thank you so very much for participating. All right. So let's go with this one. Let's begin with unit number 5. And the first topic for today is going to be this. Let me share my screen. All right. I have body parts. Okay. So you need to tell me the name of the part of the body. Let's go. Let's go. What is it? What is it?
Mouth.
Lips. And a teeth.
Okay, we only have 4 options.
Letter C.
All right, teeth. I have a question. What is the singular for teeth?
Tooth.
Excellent. Tooth. Very good. Teeth is plural. Singular is tooth. Very good. Awesome. Let's continue. Tooth. All right. Let's go. What is it? What Face. Is it?
Lips.
Lips.
Mouth.
Face.
Lips.
Letter B. Mouth. All right. Good. All right. Mouth. Good. Let's go. Let's go. What is it? What is this?
Nose.
All right.
Letter A.
All right.
Teacher, have a question.
Sure.
Nose or noose?
Nose.
Because my dog is noose.
No. It's nose. All right. Okay. What is this? What is this?
Leg.
Leg. You got it. Good. It's a leg. All right. Let's continue with the next one.
Ew.
What is it?
Eyes.
No.
Eyes.
Hand.
Neck.
Neck.
No, es neck. Aquí el cuello, no, neck.
Or finger, neck.
Neck.
Neck. Neck. Neck. Neck.
All right. All right. So let's see. What is this? What is nape? Nape. What is this?
Es siesta.
No. Siesta es nap.
Ah.
Yeah. This is nape. So what is the difference between neck and nape?
Neck sería aquí atrás del cuello.
Ooh, no. Okay, Carla. All right, excellent. Neck, neck es el cuello de aquí. La parte de atrás se llama nuca. Se llama nape.
Oh.
Good, excellent. Very good. Let's continue with the next one. What is it?
Hand.
What? Hand?
Arm.
Okay, let's see the options.
Arm.
Let's see the options.
Arm. Letter B.
Excellent. Arm. All right. Good. Good job. Arm. All right. Let's go. What is it?
It's face.
Face.
Let's see.
Face.
All right, let's see.
Head.
No.
Eyes.
Letter B.
Cool. Head. All right.
Okay.
Awesome. Let's go with the next one. Oh, what is it?
Feet.
I know feet.
Foot. Only one.
Oh, okay. Letter C. Excellent. Excellent. Foot, one. Feet,
one.
Two. Okay. Feet is plural. Foot, singular. All right. Let's continue. What is it? What is this?
Hair.
Ooh.
Hair.
All right.
Hair.
Let's go. Let's
hair.
Hair. Excellent, Carla. Good job. All right. Let's continue with the number 10. Let's go with number 10. What is this?
Air.
The pronunciation for that word?
Ear.
Oh, ear. Okay. Yeah. Okay, you got it. What letter?
Letter D.
Good. Ear. Good.
Ear.
All right. 11. Let's go with 11.
Chest.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Let's see if we have that option.
Chest.
All right. Good job. Chest. All right. Chest. All right. All right. Let's go.
Libro chest.
Uh-huh. And what about this one?
Hands or finger?
Fingers.
Letter A.
Okay.
Letter A.
Okay. I have a question. How do you say dedos del pie?
Feet finger.
No, 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 no.
Finger. Foot.
No. Ajá. Dedos del pie. No te dice fingers. Good. Thank you. Thank you. De los dedos del pie se llaman
toes.
Good. All right. So let's continue. Two more.
Let's go.
Okay.
What is it? Veamos.
All right.
Peter, but why in the song of the child say head, shoulder, knees, and toes?
Yeah, toes is the los dedos del pie. That is correct. Yep.
But I think that they say toes about the pie.
Oh no, toes is, I mean, it's está en los pies, pero son los dedos, right? So toes is the fingers, the fingers of the foot, right?
Okay. Letter B.
I'm sorry. What was the answer? I forgot it.
Letter B.
All right. B. Okay. Let's continue. The last one. Let's go.
Ice.
Good.
Ice.
Perfect. All right. Good job. Excellent. Ice. Very good. Okay. Now let's continue with the next part of the unit. So just give me 1 second. Okay, so you know the parts of the body. Los más fáciles, all right? Vamos a ver, how do you say cadera?
Hip.
Okay, hips, good.
¿Qué me puede escribir?
Sure, I'm gonna put it in the chat right here. So,
please. Hip,
very good. How do you say pestañas?
Eyelashes.
All right. Pestañas, eyelashes, good. How do you say cejas?
Eyebrow.
Eyebrow.
Eyebrows. Good. How do you say tobillo?
Tobillo.
All right. Ankle. Good. How do you say se me olvidó el nombre en español. Esto. How do you say this one?
Barbilla.
Excellent.
Chin.
How do you say this one?
Chin.
Okay.
Hi, teacher. Solo voy a dejar la clase.
Okay. Excellent.
Thanks. Gracias.
All right. Okay. So, chin. Another. Let's see. Another. How do you say hígado? Liver. La pronunciación está mala, pero la palabra está bien, Diana. Es liver. Excellent, Diana. Good. How do you say vejiga? Estamos hablando del cuerpo, vea. All right.
Balloon.
No me van a decir balloon.
Balloon.
Ladder. Ladder. Excellent. Ladder. Ladder. Good, good. Ladder. Okay. Let's see one more. One more. How do you say, how do you say intestinos?
Intestines.
Bowels.
Okay, okay. You can say bowels. You can say the bowels. Right?
Like a bowel.
Well, no, no.
Pero
si usted le pone, sí, yeah, it's good too. Si usted le cambia la B latín, la B latín, creo yo. La B de bueno, por la B, por la V, ahí es vocal.
La B
con V es vocal. La B con B de bueno es intestinos, las tripas, todo lo que va adentro, right? De
nuestro pulmones.
Yeah. Oh, how do you say pulmones?
Long.
Good. Long. Awesome. How do you say lengua?
Tongue.
Excellent. Tongue. All right. How do you say? I'm sorry?
Riñones.
Ooh, how do you say riñones?
Kidney.
All right. Kidneys. Awesome. Awesome. Let's see. Una chistosa. Let's see. How do you say mocos?
Running nose.
Si yo digo runny nose, es que tengo mucho
poco corriendo.
All right. Pero solo la palabra es snot. Good, 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 good. All right. Let's see.
Garganta. Aquí I'm sorry. Como uno dice que cuando le duele la garganta, que está fónico o algo así. Porque nos quejamos de eso mucho.
Yeah.
De la garganta.
How do you say garganta?
Throat.
Throat. Good. Alright. How do you say cheles? Oh, en la mañana.
La gaña.
Ajá, la gañita. How do you say that?
Cheles.
No.
White.
White? No.
I booger.
Boogers. Good.
Booger.
Cheles.
Booger.
All right. The boogers. Excellent. All right, people. Good job.
Camanances.
All right. Ooh, camanances.
Dimples.
Good. It's a dimple. Y si usted le cambia la D por la P, ¿qué es pimple?
Espinilla.
Excellent. Good. Dimple, los hoyuelos, son los camanances, right? Y pimple son las espinillitas. All right. Good. All right. So you know vocabulary. That's good. Awesome.
Saliva.
So, oh, how do you say saliva?
Saliva.
Just the pronunciation is different. It's saliva.
Saliva.
Pero se escribe igual. Saliva. All right. Okay. Nice. So let's continue. Let's continue with the unit number 5. This is the unit number 5. So,
teacher, what is a speed?
I'm sorry?
What is a speed?
Speed is escupir.
Ah, okay.
Ajá. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So,
teacher ya tomó la foto. The picture.
Thank you, Carla. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Ya ven que uno después de vacaciones viene un poco así aturdido. All right. All right. So smile for the picture. Smile for the picture. Let's see the smile for the picture. No, la voy a volver a tomar. Okay, la voy a volver a tomar porque alguien salió. No, ya se la voy a mandar. No, ya la borré. All right. Excellent. All right. Ya estuvo. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Awesome. Very good. Very good. So let me put it right here. Give me just one second. Okay. Thank you. Now vamos a guardarla. Let's save it and let's continue. All right. Very good. So let's continue right now with the next thing right here. So you have parts of the body, right? So you know this ones. Let's go. Let's read the ones we know. Okay. So let's begin. Please, Imelda, please read. The microphone.
Part of the body.
All right.
Head.
Eye.
Nose. Mouth.
Thank you. Continue, Wendy.
Waist. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Leg. Toe.
Excellent. Continue, Rodrigo.
Forehead.
All right. Continue.
Ear. Neck. Shoulder.
Thank you. Continue, Karen.
Chest. Stomach. Wrist.
Wrist. Ajá. La W es muda. Race.
Okay. Race.
Good. Berenice.
Knee, shin, foot, hair.
Good. Jose Cartagena.
Nape, shoulder blade,
elbow.
Hip.
Buttocks. All right. Thank you. Continue, Lillian.
Back. Finger. Think.
Right. This Five. One? Okay.
Pulse. Heel. Ankle.
Excellent. Good. Super good. So let's continue right now. All right, health problems. So we have different health problems right here. So let's see the regular or the most common problems that we have are this. These are the most regular ones. So let's see, let's begin with Dominga. Please read this ones, these five.
Yes. Wrong leg.
Okay.
Brace. A call.
One more time. One more time. Here. Bruce.
A brush.
Okay.
A call. A cough.
A cough.
A cramp.
A cramp. Okay. Guys, what is a cramp? What's a cramp?
Golpeado.
De esos que dan como a las 2 de la mañana. Cuando usted se estira en la cama. Oh my goodness. All right. Yeah.
O cuando está embarazada también.
Really?
I said.
¿De verdad?
Yes, teacher.
Les dan calambres.
You are in labor too. It's very, very hard.
Oh, pero calambres en las piernas.
Yes, teacher.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God. I'm sorry.
Se le hacen las pelotas
pero bueno.
The football.
Oh gosh. You know, you are heroes. All right.
Yes, sir.
All right. Oh gosh. All right. Let's continue. I didn't know that. That's new to me. All right. Let's continue with Mayra. Please, Mayra, continue with the next five.
Cut.
Okay.
Earache. Mm-hmm. Fever.
All right.
Hardship. A running nose.
Excellent. Oh, what'd you tell me, right? A running nose. All right, guys. Todo lo que termina en ache es dolor. Y se pronuncia ache. Example, earache. Con K. Earache, headache, stomachache. All right. Backache. All right. So very good. Very good. Now let's continue with let's see another person. Let's go with Imelda. Please, Imelda, continue with the next.
A sore throat.
Okay.
A stomachache.
Mm-mm. Stomach?
Stomach
cake.
Stomach cake.
All right.
A stuffy nose.
All right.
A sunburn.
Burn, okay.
A toothache.
Toothache. Good. Guys, what is the meaning of stuffy nose? A synonym for that one is
una nariz tapada.
All right.
Nariz tapada.
Excellent. It's a stuffy nose, like when you are tapada, that is right. Very good. Very good. Oh, I'm sorry.
Constipado.
Terrible.
Correct. Correct. So constipated. Okay. Be careful with that word. Esta palabra es de dos filos, porque si yo digo constipado en español, uno entiende que digo, oh, estoy constipado, right? Estoy blocked, is I have a blocked nose or I have a stuffy nose. Pero in English, constipated is different. ¿Qué es constipated? Si yo le digo a ustedes, fueran todos gringos ustedes, si les digo, I am constipated, no me refiero a la nariz. ¿Qué es constipated?
Tapado.
Tapado, pero...
del estómago.
Del intestino. Estreñido.
Exactly. Correct. Constipated es estreñido. Right. In English, constipated es estreñido. Those are two different words. Okay, very good. So... now we are going to continue with this one. Let's see. I'm going to give you, let's see. This is, how can we make this? Give me just 1 second. Okay. So we have this ones. Let's see the medicines that we have for this one. Okay. Wendy, please read the medicines, the regular, you know, the remedies that we have for health problems. Let's go. I can't hear you, Wendy.
Chamomile tea.
Okay, chamomile tea. Okay.
Chamomile tea, cough syrup.
Okay.
Chicken salt.
Soup.
Cold medicine.
All right.
Eye drop.
Okay.
Aspirin.
All right.
Antacid.
Antacid, all right.
Antacid. Nasal spray.
Nasal.
Nasal spray.
All right.
Ice pack.
Excellent. So we have chamomile tea. La receta de las abuelitas, right? The chamomile tea, right? Cough syrup, chicken soup, cold medicine, eye drop, aspirin, antacid, nasal spray, and ice pack. All right? So, let's see. Let's see. In groups, you are going to give me the medicine for some health problems. All right? Los mismos grupos. Let's see. Oh, let me recreate the groups right now. Okay. Group number one. Please pay attention and write. Mayra, Jose, Brenda, Imelda, Lizzie, and Lillian. You need to give me the remedies or the medicine for a bruise, a cold, and a cough. Group number one. Group number one. A bruise, a cold, and a cough. And listen, I am talking about remedies. Los remedios caseros, no de medicina, right? Remedios caseros. What do we do for a cold, a bruise, and a cough? Let's continue. Number two, Marvin, Diana, Pamela, Ana Daisy, and Karen. Remedies for a cramp, a cut, and an earache. All right? One more time. A cramp, a cut, and an earache. Number three, Carla, Melvin, Katia, Andrea Reyes, and Rodrigo, the remedies for fever. Number two, headache. And number three, runny nose. Fever, headache, and runny nose. All right? And let's finish with group number four. Andrea Argueta, Berenice, Dominga, Astrid, and Wendy, you are going to give me the remedies for a sore throat. Right. Sore throat. Number two, stomachache. All right. And number three, sunburn. Sunburn. The remedies. Ready? Let's go. Let's go. I'm going to give you 6-7 minutes, and then we come back to the main session to discuss the remedies. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go right now. Everybody to the breakout rooms, please. Everybody there. All right. Let's go, everyone. Let's go to the breakout rooms, please. All right. Let's go, Brenda, and let's go, Marvin.
No, ni yo, yo
pero, dentro de esos está el... Ay, no recuerdo, el té de manzanilla.
Medio cafero.
Sí, ajá. Hay que buscar... ¿Alguien sabe cómo se dice jengibre, eucalipto? El
por
teacher, el primero no le entendí, dijo cool, cough, y anterior de eso dijo uno. No sé
yes.
Cuál es.
Exactly. Bruce.
¿Qué es? Meaning?
Moretones.
Ah.
Bruce. Yeah. Bruce.
Híjole. Eso
está
All right. Difícil.
All right. Okay. Let's go.
Okay. Entonces.
Ginger. Ginger is jengibre.
Jengibre.
Ginger.
alcohol o limón?
Alcohol, hell.
Ay. Ah, yo pensé que tequila.
No, tequila. Tequila.
Es para la gripe.
Okay, you can, but for the cook, the first, clean your area and
water and soup. Water and soup.
Water.
¿Cómo se dice jabón? Soup. Marvin, chicken soup. Chicken soup. Ah, chicken. Es sopa. Chicken soup. Oh, okay. Okay. So. Oh, excellent. Very good. Very good. All right. Entonces, water and soup.
Uh-huh. And then you put cream. What's the name of the cream?
Let me see, cold water compress, mentol and cornwood. Sí. Para el dolor de cabeza, espérame, quiero ver.
Para el dolor de cabeza.
La fiebre.
Sí.
Mentol alcoholado para el dolor de cabeza. Y el Vaporú, sí.
La rosa, también la ponemos.
Y el otro era el congestionamiento de la.
Ah, sí.
Pone esa solución salina, lavado de solución salina en nasales.
También, sabe, también hay personas que se ponen un ajo en la nariz, un diente de ajo en la nariz, y con ese salen los mocos.
Pero eso te quema. Hecho, el ajo quema.
Ya he visto, bueno, eso sí va, pero ya he visto personas que lo hacen. Pero
solución salina.
Solución salina, de ella no se quema. Ah, también el vapor. Vapor de, creo que limón con eucalipto, no sé, o menta, creo, no estoy segura, pero algo así es.
Te puedes poner Big Vaporú, eucalipto y manzanilla. Ajá. Es que el ajo sí te quema. El ajo sí quema. Water compress para la fiebre, mentol. Eso parece. Solución salina es también para la nariz. Dejarlo bueno el ajo que dice la compañera ahí, no sé. Está bien. Cold water.
La pregunta es, ¿cómo se dice solución salina?
All right. No, es saline solution.
okay. Similar.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a regular name. So the medical name for that one is salt solution. Salt solution.
Salt solution.
Okay. That is correct.
Solution.
You finished?
Yes,
teacher.
Ooh, you're super fast. All right. Awesome. Awesome. So let me ask, can you tell me the health problems and what are the solutions for those? I need three people. I gave you three problems. Now give me three solutions. So I need Wendy, I need Berenice, and I need Astrid. So let's see. Wendy?
Uh,
Bueno, para el dolor de garganta es
for the sore throat.
For honey, lemon and ginger.
Oh, okay. Honey, lemon and ginger. I eat them?
No, drink.
Oh, I prepare what? Like a tea?
Tea.
Excellent.
Tea?
I prepare a hot tea, okay, with honey. What else?
Lemon and ginger.
Lemon and ginger. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Berenice.
El problema era.
The problem was.
The problem was stomach.
Stomachache. All right.
The ¿cómo es remedio?
Yeah, a remedy.
Remedy is cinnamon tea. Water,
okay.
Cinnamon.
Cinnamon tea.
And
yeah.
Guava leaves.
Okay.
In tea.
Oh, with that in a tea. Okay.
Creo.
Okay.
I think. Mm-hmm.
Very good. So that's good for a stomachache. Nice. Astrid?
For a sunburn, we put aloe vera and mustard? Mostaza?
Yes.
For what is the problem?
Sunburn.
Oh, for a sunburn? For a sunburn, mustard? Should I like put mustard on my body, or should I drink it, or what's the remedy?
In your body.
You put it on your body.
Cream.
Okay. Creams. Very good. Very good. Now, let me ask you. Cuando ustedes ponen hojas secas y le echan agua, how do you say that?
Eso no es un té.
Exactly.
Infusión.
Exactly. That's an infusion. All right? That's not a tea. That's an infusion. All right? Con todo lo que sea seco, que yo le pongo agua hirviendo para que
despida.
Thank you. Despida. That's an infusion, not a tea. Right? Excellent. Good job, girls. Very good. All right, let's go to the main session right now. Okay, so they are coming back right now. Let's see, we have 8 people. Okay, very good. Now we are together one more time. So I will mention the health problem and you tell me the solution, the remedy for that. All right, so let's begin. I need a remedy for a cold. Let's go. A remedy for a cold? Anybody? I mean, del grupo que le tocó cold, right? So anybody from that group, can you tell me a remedy for a cold?
Chamomile tea?
Chamomile?
Chamomile tea?
All right.
And chicken soup.
Okay.
Big Vaporu.
Oh.
Rook Big Vaporu on chest.
Okay. Vaporu. All right. That's in Spanish. That is in Spanish. The correct pronunciation for this one in English is vapor, vapor, vaporab. So big vapor de vapor y rub de untar. So big vaporab.
Vapor.
All right, good. Okay, let's continue.
No necesito decir rub big vap. Solo vapor, big vapor on chest.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Porque exactly. Ya va incluida la palabra, entonces.
Exactly. Correct. Now, another remedy for a cough. Cough. A remedy for that.
Ginger tea.
Okay.
And chamomile tea.
Chamomile, ginger.
Chamomile.
Okay.
Eucalyptus.
Okay.
And honey bee.
Honey bee or just honey?
Just honey.
Just honey. Yeah, just honey. All right, good. Let's continue. Cramp.
Jose Rolando.
Okay, Rolando. Cramp. What can I do for a cramp?
Clean with water.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I'm sorry, Marvin.
Do it, Marvin.
Ah, dale.
Do it, you.
Don't fight.
You.
Se peleen por participar. Let's go. All right, Marvin, let's go.
I clean with water and.
Oh, but that's a cut. Okay, let's go with a cut. Okay, let's go.
Okay. Cut.
Yep. Yeah.
Es cat dijo.
Yep.
Clean with water and soap. How do you say soap?
Yep. Soap. Uh-huh.
And put, ¿cómo se dice gasa?
Oh, how do you say gasa? Or how do you say gasa?
You say gauze.
Gauze.
All right. All right. Pero... ¿Cómo se dice curita? ¿Qué es más común, digamos?
Causita. No, mentira.
Band. Aid.
Band.
A band-aid. Ah, una curita, all right? Good. Okay. Next. Let's continue with the next one. Fever.
Teacher Joe.
All right.
Cool water compress. And take a shower.
Okay. Yeah, mm-hmm. Very simple. Very simple. Mm-hmm. Good. Let's continue with a stomachache. Let's go with a stomachache.
Oh. Infusión, como dijo. Infusión.
Infusion.
Hojas infusion of the hojas de leaves guayaba, hojas de guayaba.
Guava leaves.
Guava leaves.
All right. Infusion of guava leaves. Okay.
Yes.
Good. Let's continue. Thank you, Dominga. Let's do one more. Let's go with a runny nose. What can I do for a runny nose?
Que hable otro compañero del grupo. Nosotros nos tocó ese.
Okay. Katia. Anybody else? A runny nose. What can I do for a runny nose? Or what can I do for a stuffy nose? A runny nose or a stuffy nose? Any volunteer? Let's go.
For runny nose.
Okay, let's see, Katia.
Saline's, ah, bueno, dijeron salt. Salt solution in the nose or garlic clove in the nose?
All right, so good. So we have both. Salt solution, solution salina, salt solution, or a more unusual remedy is just to put a piece of garlic on your nostrils. ¿Cómo se llaman los hoyitos de la nariz? Se llaman nostrils. All right? Porque la nariz es toda es todo esto enterito. Los hoyitos se llaman nostrils. So you put a garlic in the nostrils. They say, I don't know, I'm not sure.
Very dangerous because it's hot for the skin.
For the skin, all right. Okay. Yes. So
the garlic is very hot.
It's very hot, that's correct. Yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you very much. Remember something. Tienen 24 horas para hacer su examen y para mandarme la nota. Please, les pido de favor, su nota, su nombre y la hora. Ana, perdón, me pone ahí la nota, Ana Daisy, 4 p.m. Así yo me voy directamente a la lista de las 4 p.m., busco a Ana Daisy y pongo su nota. All right, Wendy.
Teacher, la nota del examen oral, esa no la mandó, ¿verdad?
Les pido mil disculpas porque, gracias que me dijo Mayra, les mandé las notas equivocadas porque tienen todos ceros. Uh-huh. Entonces, no es esa. Ya la voy a actualizar con la que tengo y la revisan, ¿ok?
Ok, gracias.
Okay, girls and boys, thank you very much. Welcome again after vacations. See you tomorrow at 4. Remember,
okay, so
okay, four days, okay? So thank you. Be good.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Take care.